for numerical interpolation. So here you can apply this method in case of equal or unequal data size, any of it. When step size is equal or unequal, both it is applicable for. But speciality is unequal data size. So irrespective of the spacing between the values of x, you can apply the Lagrange's interpolation. Let us see the formula and we'll solve one numerical so that you can easily understand it. So yr is equal to, yr is the required value of y at corresponding value of x. So yr is equal to xr minus x1. See here, okay, it is very important. Total 1, 2, 3, 4 or 5, 6 depending upon number of data points. So many steps are going to be there. So this is the first step. So in the numerator, we are omitting x0. Huh? See here, xr minus x1, xr minus x2, xr minus x3 and so on till the last data point divided by x0. Now here in the denominator, you have to take x0 in the first step. So x0 minus x1, x0 minus x2 up to last data point, x0 minus xn into y0. Okay, plus second step is you have to omit now x1. So it is xr minus x0, xr minus x2. Okay, x1 is omitted here. Xr minus x3 up to the last data point divided by x1 minus x0, x1 minus x2, x1 minus x3 and so on. Now third step will be what? Xr minus x0, xr minus x1. Now x2 you have to omit. So x2 is missing here. Okay. Divided by x2 minus x0, x2 minus x1, x2 minus x3 and so on. Likewise, you have to travel till the last data point. I hope you have understood the formula. Let us solve a numerical so that it will be more clear to you. Okay. Find the interpolating polynomial using Lagrange's formula and divided difference also you can apply. So presently we are solving the numerical with Lagrange's formula. So x is given as 1, 2, 3, 5. So step size is not same. Y is given as 0, 7, 26, 1, 24. So this we are knowing with, okay. So let us apply the Lagrange's formula. And we are interested to find out what we are interested to find out? Yr at corresponding value of xr. Okay, but yr directly we have to form the equation, polynomial equation we are interested to find out. So see the formula. It is xr minus x1, xr minus xr minus x1, xr minus x2, xr minus x3, because this is the first step. Only up to x3 we have four data points, x0, x1, x2, x3. So formula is up to x3 only, divided by x0 minus x1, x0 minus x2, x0 minus x3 into y0. Plus next step will be what? Xr minus x0, xr minus x1 you have to omit here. So it is omitted, xr minus x2, xr minus x3. Divided by x1 minus x0, x1 minus x2, x1 minus x3 into y1. Now next term will be what? Xr minus x0, xr minus x1, xr minus x3 directly. X2 you have to omit because you have to multiply it by y2. Okay. Divided by x2 minus x0, x2 minus x1 and x2 minus x3. Similarly, the last term xr minus x0, xr minus x1, xr minus x2. So x3 we are not taking. So denominator will be x3 minus x0, x3 minus x1, x3 minus x2 into y3. So you have all these values except xr. So xr is kept as it is. And if we solve it, you will get the equation xr cube minus 1. So the polynomial will be f of x will be x cube minus 1. Okay. So if the value of xr is given to you, then sometimes some other data point you can easily find out. So you can apply this method to any of the numerical that we have solved up till today and you can cross check the answers as well. Okay. So I hope you have understood Lagrange's interpolation. Here we will stop. Okay. Thank you for today.